So what do you do if you're on a walk to help your back and your back attacks on your walk? What do? There's a really easy stretch. So the best stretch for that is actually to put your foot up on a stair or a step. This is a little bit taller, but this will work fine if you can find a bench. If you have really good balance, you can do it like this. You want to make sure you have your toe pointing straight up, and you're just going to hang out here for a minute. If you don't have really good balance, make sure you're at a stairway and you can hold on to the railing to keep yourself safe. So you're just going to hang out like this, let it stretch for a minute, and then do the other side. You want to hold it for a minute. If you can't quite hold it for a minute, then at least try to go for 30 seconds and build up your tolerance. What this is going to do is when you're on your walk, what's happening is if most of the time when people have back pain, they have weakness in their glutes, and so they need stronger butt muscles. And if you're having pain, then what's happening is those butt muscles are weak. And what's happening as you walk is these muscles in here are getting tight because your femur, your thigh bone, is caving in on you due to the weakness here. All right, and so you're alleviating the tightness that's developing here by doing this stretch. And that's also taking pressure off your back, because if everything's collapsing in, it's gonna pull your back forward too. So this stretch helps open up everything on the front to alleviate the pressure on the back. Just try it. You'll find that it helps quite a bit. Okay. So since I talked about what you could do if your back attacks you on your walk, you have a stretch now to do. But what if you want to prevent your back attacking you on your walk? Well, most likely, again, you need to do some strengthening for your butt muscles and your core. We have a lot of stuff on YouTube and social media about different things you can do for that. But one really easy thing to start adding into your life, you can actually do seated, and you're gonna put your feet on the ground. You wanna have a 90 degree angle like this. You're gonna push your feet into the ground, squeezing your butt, pull the heels back without sliding, and then relax. Now, something you might not have noticed when I did this is what happened is I went from a neutral spine with a small little arch in my back to when I activated my glutes and my hamstrings, that pulled my pelvis into a tuck, rounding my back. All right, and so what that's doing is it's activating key stabilizing muscles of my spine to help my back to stay happier with me. So let's review. You're gonna put your hands on your lower back. You're gonna squeeze your butt as you push your feet into the ground. Pull the heels back without sliding to activate those hamstrings as well. And you can see how that moves my back into my hands. Try it with your hands on your back so you can feel that happening. All right, once you've got it down with two legs, try it with just one leg. Same exact thing. Okay, and then once you've got that down, then try it with one leg and lift the opposite leg. So when I lift the opposite leg, I'm pulling in some of the muscles on the front of my body as well that help stabilize my spine. When I'm just doing it without the leg lift, it's mostly muscles on the back of the body. Adding the leg lift, it's a comprehensive strengthening exercise.